Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we'll go over how to use Subtotal in Excel. Using Subtotal is an easy way to summarize data so that it can be easier to understand. In our example, we'll first use the Subtotal button found in the Data tab, and then we'll go over how to use the Subtotal function. And by the way, if you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to this channel for even more tips. On my screen is some sales data I made up. It's organized by year, associate, product, quantity sold, and the amount of dollars generated from those sales. Before using the Subtotal button, the first thing we'll want to do is sort the data. In this case, we'll sort by year. We'll go over why in a moment. Placing your cursor in the data, find the Outline section in your Data tab and click Subtotal. In the pop-up box, the first thing we need to note is what we want to subtotal by. So when a subtotal is inserted, a new row will also be inserted to accommodate the subtotaled result. So I was planning to subtotal by year, so that means at the end of all the 2016s, for example, a row will be inserted for the subtotals. Then select the function you'd like to use. In this case, I want to see total quantity sold and total dollars sold by year, so we'll select the sum function. Lastly, we need to choose which columns we want to subtotal, so quantity sold and dollars sold, and click OK. This automatically creates an outline of the data and displays a summary of the quantity sold and dollars generated by year. It also created this new area over here to the left of the screen. This is a representation of how the data is grouped, as well as a tool you can use to control how you see the summary of your data. For example, notice this bracket shape around 2016 that ends with a minus sign. Click on the minus sign and it hides the data except for the subtotals. Click on the plus sign to see the detail again. You can also use these buttons near the top to control the amount of detail that you see. The higher the number, the more detail. Click on 1 and you see only the grand total. Click on 2 and you see the subtotals by year. Click on 3 and you see all your data. To make a change or remove the subtotals, simply click on the subtotal button again to bring up the options box. To show you why it's important to sort the data ahead of time, let's say we change one of these years to 2017. When I click the subtotal button again, notice how it adds a second subtotal for 2017. This could just get really messy. So to keep the spreadsheet easier to read, it's best to sort it by however you want to organize it before subtotaling. So if we take a closer look at our subtotals, we see that each uses the subtotal function. This means you can also make edits right in this function or just type the function and use it without clicking on the subtotals button. If you use it by itself, the difference is that you won't get the summary brackets over here on the left. This function is made up of two things, a math calculation and the cells you want to subtotal. So if we rewrite it, you see that there are 11 calculations to choose from to subtotal data. But if we scroll, we see that each is repeated, but in the hundreds. The difference being that choosing the ones in the hundreds will only include cells that are visible. Here's what I mean. So our example uses 9 for sum. Let's recreate it right next to it, but using 109 and selecting the same data. And let's add filters at the top. Notice how if I filter out a year, both subtotals change equally to 0. Let's remove the filters. But notice if I were to hide some of these rows, only the subtotal that used the 109 changed. That's because all subtotals exclude filtered cells, but using the calculations in the 100s also excludes hidden cells. In case you were wondering about the difference between using subtotal versus sum, that's one of them. Sum will add regardless of visibility. Another difference between using the subtotal function versus sum, average, or whatever other calculation, is that subtotal allows you to do more calculations on the same data without including the subtotaled results. Notice what happens if I use subtotal again on all of this data, including the existing subtotals, versus if I were just to use sum. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to do subtotal in Microsoft Excel. If you did, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.